In the Northwest and in Puget Sound and Whatcom County, salmon are far more than just fish and just food. They're part of who we are. Experiencing the return of the salmon and the awe of that magical procession, and then eating these same fish and knowing that it came from where we live brings this amazing sense of connection.
We've become a place where thousands and thousands more people are going to move. The question is going to be whether or not we can protect this place, this glorious region, and get to a place where we live in ways that are sustainable. And the fundamental thing that we're trying to protect is represented by the middle fork of the Nooksack River.
That's what it's all about. Food. We're trying to get this salmon into that habitat above that diversion so it can make babies, so it'll come back numerous generations.
It's not every day you get to take down a dam. The dam went in without fish passage. At the time, that was the norm. It doesn't make it right. We're in a position now where we can recognize that and say, okay, we as the city benefit so much from getting our water from the Middle Fork. So it helped our city be economically strong and have safe, reliable drinking water. We still want to keep that in the future, but how can we structure our intake so that we do have fish passage now and that we have a free-flowing river?
We have river systems in our state that have no life. So when we see something like the Middle Fork Diversion Dam, the removal of that dam and allowing that passage, that's a win for us, you know. It's a win for everybody.
We've had such a strong partnership with the tribes and Department of Fish and Wildlife. We were able to work really well with American Rivers, and they were able to bring in their partnerships with the Paul Allen Family Foundation for a significant amount of funding. We were able to bring in funding from the state and from several other grant sources. To see all of those entities come together in support of a single project, that gets me excited. I like all that.
The project absolutely would not be happening without partnerships, and in fact, the right partnerships. If we were missing any one of our partners, the project's at risk of not happening.
After 15 years, many, many hours by many council members, three mayors, staffs, and other jurisdictions, we are very proud here to have this project going forward.
I hope that our project sets a great example of being a project where what might initially appear as competing objectives or goals can be married together to a point where a solution's found that really benefits everybody.
Every battle won is a cause for celebration, but let's get back out there and get to work because there's more to be done.
The dam is only a symptom of a bigger picture. It's going to take everybody working together to do this.
If you got a beating heart, you know, come down to the river and look at it. Any body of water running clean, you can see life all around, you can hear the birds, and it's refreshing. We're very fortunate to be able to see it today. Without our help, it's going to go away.
We don't just do a project like this and call it done. We also have to do the hard work of altering our relationship to the land so that we can pass something on to future generations.